Okay, so I was telling you about the different applications which are used by the Swift network. So it provides different solutions in case of trade service utility. In case of trade services, we have trade service utility. So consider this, you know, very simple example wherein, you know, there is a buyer who is like a kind of importer. There is a seller who is kind of an exporter, okay? And he is going to request, the buyer is going to request a seller that please send me so-and-so good on so-and-so date with so-and-so quantity and the kind of remuneration. Details are also there. So this is a purchase order which is issued by a buyer to a seller. And in response to that, it is going to approach the bank and, you know, going to check with the bank whether, you know, the credibility of the buyer and, the, you know, receive a letter of credit for the shipment and the kind of insurance it is going to buy and so on and so forth. The same is being, you know, done at the buyer's end because the buyer has also, you know, made a purchase order and sent it across. So it is going to approach his bank and the both the banks is going to communicate with the help of trade service utility. Now, once the confirmation is being given by the trade service utility, yes, there is an order received by the from the buyer side, the, which is being verified at the seller's end, like, you know, this is the quantity, this is the amount, this is the date, and so on and so forth. Shipment is going to be sent, okay? Now, the shipment is sent, like, buyer has received the you know, requested quantities and everything. Now, it is going to verify against what it has sent in the purchase order. Again, the trade service utility, it's being sent to trade service utility. The same details of the shipment as being sent to the trade service utility. Now here the trade service utility plays a very important role by making a matching mechanism. You know, what is being received, what has been sent, what has been requested, what has been received. So this kind of mechanism makes it very correct and, you know, direct for both the parties that, you know, agreed upon for trading. So this is one of the application example which is sent, you know, which is being provided by the Swift network. So Swift provides this TSU application, that is trade service utility application. There are a number of applications in different space. They have compliance related applications like know your customer. They have AML check for anti-money laundering and, you know, crime investigation and fraudulent customers and organizations, you know. There are, you know, a couple of business intelligence applications that they you know, provide to customers, like dashboards, you know, to view the kind of messages that are flowing to the network for that particular financial institution. So if I'm a regional head and I would like to see in the APAC region, like thousands of transactions which got processed during this stipulated time and what all transactions got failed. Now I want to filter out the only high value payments out of which, you know, went through the authorization, but somehow it got in between stuck. So this becomes very easier for me to monitor, to see the very dashboard view, which is like a real time, and the reporting becomes very easy and quick. So these kind of business intelligence softwares are also provided by the Swift applications. So this is on the solutioning part. On the services side, we already discussed that Swift provides a common messaging applications, okay? So it is like the communication with which both the parties agreed upon and can talk to each other. So let's say I'm talking in English and probably you are able to receive the communication what I'm, you know, talking because you understand the same language. Here both the parties understand the same language. The Swift defines the codes of message which is called message types, empty messages. So it has series of different messages categorized into different parts. Let's say MT1XX to MT9XX. It can be treasury messages, it could be bank or financial exchange messages, it could be customer request transfer messages, it could be customer status messages, and so on and so forth. Now, this is all about the types of, it is all about the how the application and the service is provided by the Swift network. Now, there are different types of messages as we talk. It is still categorized into different categories, let's say financial messages. So all the empty messages that we already discussed just now fall into FIN category, okay? So it has different modes of communication. So both the parties understand the FIN messages. So it can go in the real time, which is like quick sent and directly received by the other party. Now the only challenge is if this financial institution do not have that application which understand this message or can receive this message at that point of time. So Swift works in the store and forward mode as well. where it stores the message, it waits till the time this application is up and running, and then it sends the message. This makes an assurance that, you know, the whatever is sent is being received by the other end. Okay, so these are the different mechanisms with which the fin message works. There are five legs. So we quoted an example where, you know, the bulk payments are made by the corporate at the end of the month or fortnight. One of the example could be salary payments. So these are the bulk messages which cannot be generated by, you know, one by one. So we generate files of it. Okay, and these files are being triggered at some particular interval, let's say 30th of every month, and being sent to the SWIFT network, where the other banking application where the actual employees are residing, and there it gets credit, you know, the amount gets credited in their account. So this is about the file act. The interact talks about the MX messages or the XML messages, the pain messages, PAX messages, and so forth, which is like industry standard, you know, governed by the ISO standard. And there are browse messages, let's say individual transactions, if somebody is willing to you know, trigger and create the messages on the bank side, so they can trigger it using the browse facility. So these are the facilities given by the SWIFT network. Now this is all about, you know, the how the SWIFT works, what all applications it provides, how the communication takes place between the SWIFT, but how does it earn the revenue? Okay, so basically this is a society of interbank financial telecommunication where it has different membership with the financial institution. So when you try to get the membership in the SWIFT network, you have to pay an initial amount. Okay, once you are a member, you, depending on your volume, number of data, kind of transactions, or type of payment, you will be categorized into one of the category. Let's say gold, silver, and probably platinum. So let's say you have a high or huge amount of data wherein, you know, you are the topmost customer, you'll be categorized into that category. And accordingly, you will be charged for the annual maintenance of the SWIFT network. And finally, the solutions which is offered, like TSUs, the KYC application, the AML that we talked about, the dashboard, the business intelligence applications. So these are applications also which are being charged to govern the revenue of the SWIFT application. Now, what are the challenges right now in the SWIFT market? So once the, you know, setup is established, we have 10,000 plus customers, the communication is going seamless, everything is, you know, going hunky-dory. But what are the challenges? So now understand the situation where, you know, you want to transfer a fund for 3 lakh customers, okay? And you need to create a file, okay? So this file has to be done somehow automatically, which helps in, you know, creation of the messages, transmission of the messages, and processing of the messages seamlessly. Here the automation is needed. There are a couple of applications which is launched by Swift for doing this kind of automation. However, it is still, you know, the costing becomes, you know, so deciding factors for making this financial institution to go ahead with these kind of challenges. There are other global financial messaging systems available in the market now, like we have Chips, we have Ripple, we have other financial messaging applications, but it has not penetrated till, you know, where SWIFT has already reached. And it is very obvious for any bank or financial institution, because the risk is huge. The already set up network which is working fine cannot be replaced with something which is like new to me, and I don't have, you know, certain benchmarking available as a part of this as well. So far what we have seen is still the dominance of the SWIFT network for next couple of years. Now I would try to summarize what we have learned so far. So we have started the flow with the cash management services, the different functions of the cash management services like payments, receivables, liquidity, channel services, trade, service utility, and, you know, so on and so forth. We moved to the bank example wherein we have explained that, you know, how the transaction of the, you know, fund transfer takes place between the two different banks. With a simple customer like me and probably my friend Jack, who is residing in the South Africa. We have explained, you know, what is the SWIFT network, where the SWIFT come into picture, history of it, how it has penetrated into market, what are the different users, who are the users of the SWIFT network, why they use it. We moved on to the different applications, the solutions and services provided by the SWIFT network. The types of messages it is using, like financial messages, different files for processing their payments, the MX or the XML messages, and so on and so forth. The revenue model, how SWIFT earns revenue and keeps involving, innovating new things. The challenges it is going to face and right now facing, how it is trying to overcome it. And that's it, guys. I believe I've covered everything what I have to cover for today. And I'm sure it has been an informative session. Thank you so much. Thank you.